Unhinged podcast. I'm Zena.
And I'm Danny.
And today we have a very special guest. He goes by the name of Flexx Carter. Say hello, Flexx.
Hello, Flexx.
Hey.
Flexx is an Irish hip hop artist from Waterford. But before we get stuck in with Flexx, we're going to do some recaps.
Okay.
Of the previous episode, right?
Yeah. Let's hear it.
Did you listen to the last episode?
I listened to snippets on Reels. It was the one you were talking about, sex, wasn't it?
Yeah, that one.
He doesn't listen to the podcast. No. So our last episode, we talked all about different kind of kinks and stuff, right? Okay, so I got a few recaps. Someone said, fisting. I didn't understand it until I tried it and I had no idea how enjoyable it would be. I'm a male and I enjoy it. Done to me by my bit on the side since my girlfriend isn't into it.
So he gets fisted.
He gets fisted, yeah. He loves being fisted.
But must be a small hand to get into a man's butthole.
Yeah, like by a dude or by like
by a dude, yeah.
He likes getting it done by a...
He likes getting it done by his bit on the side because his girlfriend won't fist him.
Yeah, we don't know if the bit on the side is male or female, but like just let's not skip past
the part. I'd say female because smaller fist.
Yeah. Do you think you'd have a fist up your bum?
No.
No?
Nah.
Have you ever had anything up your bum?
No.
No, don't lie now. Don't lie.
This is safe space. We're all friends here.
No one's gonna hear this.
Right. Yeah, if no one's gonna hear it, I had a pen.
A pen?
Yeah.
A pen.
A pen, yeah.
How the fuck did the pen get up your bum?
Complete joke.
Did you put it up there?
No, I didn't. No.
Was it not your that pen it makes it sound any fucking better.
No, it was actually it was someone from the past.
Right, someone from the past.
Not someone who passed, someone from the past.
Thanks for clarifying. So you're not up there with Zena's man,
no,
great.
Yes.
Okay,
so we're gonna need a backstory.
Literally just as a joke. Like it was just like
let's see if we can fit a pen up.
Yeah.
I'm not gay. You're not gay? Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Nah.
What like, colour pen was it?
Straight as I thought, it was one of those Bic multicolour ones.
Oh! Very diverse of you.
Yes.
That makes it gayer.
A rainbow pen.
A rainbow pen up the butthole.
Rainbow.
Perfect.
Right, okay, lovely. Right, next one. Mm. Golden showers. Something about that warm piss running over me gets me going.
Mm.
Yeah. Have you ever pissed on anyone, Flexx?
Nah,
that's not for you.
No.
Out of the question.
I'm saying like, no, God, no. Like, I didn't just say about the pen. But like,
yeah. No, never. Yeah. Okay, there was a rainbow pen up my ass.
Because the pen's not worse than piss.
Nah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Nah, yeah, nah, nah, nah.
Not at all.
Nah.
Right, so there are our last two recaps from
what
the previous
episode. Were you like, to the golden showers?
I would let someone piss on me, yeah.
Oh, yeah, she's really into it.
Not really into it, but I'm not like opposed to her.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Just please piss on me, Jade. Why?
I've done it a couple of times in the shower and you've not.
You have never pissed on me in the shower.
No, but she needs to know.
Washing my hair and going for a piss and I'm just like,
do you piss in the shower?
Obviously.
Do you piss in the shower?
Oh, yeah.
I would actually hold it
instead of pissing the toilet to piss in the shower.
Yeah, but you know when the water hits your shoulders and you get that little, you're like,
yeah.
Or the heat down your legs. Like,
yeah. It just comes out voluntarily. You don't even have to push.
Do you ever shit in the shower?
So much less effort, like.
Do you ever shit in the shower?
No.
Do you ever shit yourself?
Me neither.
You have to wash it in the shower because you had no toilet roll?
No, but I know somebody that's...
Come on.
Men have a habit of shitting themselves. What was with men and Sharton?
I shot myself on a run before.
On a run?
Yeah, I actually have a really good...
Tell us, this
is genuine. Like, I'm not bullshitting or anything, right? I was out for a run, right? I was coming home from my ex-girlfriend's house.
Yeah.
And it was like... It was really bad. It was really rainy out. So I was like, fuck it. I'm going to run home.
Yeah.
It's not like fire or anything.
Yeah.
So I was running... And I like took a step, shot all over, right? And like, yeah. And so I was like, oh my God.
Did you know the shit was coming? Like,
no.
It just came out of nowhere.
Yeah, it was a surprise one. Yeah, it was a jack in the box. Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow. That was the pen. Yeah. The pen loose the goose.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that was probably it. Yeah. So basically, I was down the alleyway, right? It was milling rain. And so I took everything off down the alleyway. I was like, okay, there's no one going to be able
to.
So took the boxers off, right? And then I saw this dog, like it's just like a stray, like come over. I swear to God, this is true. And he had no collar or nothing. And he was just kind of. I tried to get him to move. So he's just.
He's going to fit right in.
He was standing there, like, kind of like, you know, look at that kind of playful kind of. And I was like, so he started to come over and I was like, please, I started to talk to the dog. I was like trying to get some soul kind of connection.
Yeah, I get,
like
yeah.
we're both living beings. Like, please fuck off. So I took the boxers off and I just fucked them onto the floor.
And in the alleyway.
Yeah, put my tracksuit bottoms back on and the dog took off with the boxers.
Yeah. There's some homeless person now that's starving after finding them boxers and is eating them for nutritional value.
It's how the world goes.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
how the world
it's the
goes.
The ecosystem.
Yeah, it's the ecosystem. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Perfect. Right. Flexx, yeah. right? Before we get started, right, we've got a couple of questions in for you, let's right? But tell us a little bit about yourself and who you are and what you do.
Yeah, so I make hip hop and I've only been doing it like a little over a year now. And like, cause I was saying like a while ago, like I didn't know what a chord was and nothing like that. And like, I just got to a stage in my life where I was like, what am I really interested in? And that was like music. Like music is what, like I'm listening to it. My dad used to play like Biggie, Tupac, Eminem, 50 Cent.
I grew up on all that as well. Yeah,
so like, I was like, that's my genuine love. Yeah. So like, I was like, I have to do it. Like if I don't do it now, I'm never going to do it. You get one crack at a whip. Like even like anyone watching or listening, like, it's like, if you love something, just fucking just do it. Like, take the chance.
If
like,
it fails, it fails. Yeah. Exactly. If it works, it works.
Yeah, like, we're all going to be dead. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, you may as well fucking...
So what, might, what made you kind of like what was your what was your starting point? You were like, so I'm gonna really, did you just start like writing for yourself or
like, to be honest, I actually do, like I want to change people's lives through music. Like I do, I want to make people fucking happy. I want to make people that like maybe they, I don't know, maybe they, I never got like bullied or anything like that. I've never had fucking mental
with a face like that. No.
No,
you wouldn't get
bullied.
Pretty
privileged.
Pretty privileged. Yeah,
so I was pretty lucky. To be honest, like, even like mental health, nothing like that, right? But so I kind of, I'm always in a pretty good mood, to be honest. So I want to try push that out to people who aren't.
Just, I get you.
You know, like there's people out there that have a Spotify account and a fucking pair of earphones.
Yeah.
And it's like, I would like to be the dude that like they go home and listen
and
to.
And it uplifts their mood.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
That's so sweet.
Yeah, that's
it's the, almost like you didn't have pen shoved up your arse a few minutes ago.
Yeah. It wasn't a few minutes ago.
I swear.
That was ages ago.
Right. Well, me and Danny are very happy that you've agreed to come on to the podcast. Chat, we're delighted to have you here. But are you ready for the questions?
Probably not, but like let's do it, you know what I mean? Let's get into it.
We got some questions in by our followers and some questions in from your followers, I assume. Danny, do you want to go first?
No, you can go first.
Okay. First question.
Okay.
Are you single? What's your preference? And if you're into men, can I have your number?
Oh my God. Brilliant. Fucking brilliant. Straight into the gay stuff. Okay.
The pen just opened the gate.
So like I'm actually like, I'm actually really straight.
Yeah.
Like right, that, I actually am. Like I'm just...
Yeah, well,
straight.
That's fair, though.
You know,
so straight is homophobic.
I'm actually borderline homophobic. I straight as a die. I am seeing someone now at the moment. Yeah. Just the last little while, so we're just hitting it off, you know.
It's just the beginning. Nice. How long is it?
Like, is it like a situationship or is it like a court?
You know, it kind of was a situationship, and then it just kind of, you know, way things kind of
transitions.
So, like, weeks.
Weeks.
Yeah.
Oh, weeks.
In,
only weeks.
Infancy.
In the infancy. Okay. Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. So no, he's not going to suck your dick. I'm really sorry.
But thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's cool.
Well, it's only a few weeks. Hold on, long finger.
It's a waiting game. Give him a while.
It's
if
fine.
The pen could do it.
Flexx. Yeah. The people want to know what your most prominent kinks are. So what really gets you going?
Let me see. Just like straight just up
pussy.
Nudity. Honestly, like I'm like the fucking basics.
Yeah.
Like just like
you can't go wrong with the basics.
No, you can't. Like I actually like I don't want to disappoint anyone and be like, oh, like I like pens. You know. It's just like the basics.
Clearly.
You know, yeah, clearly.
So no mad kinks there for anyone. Like, has to be something. Something in the back of your mind that you think
about.
Well,
he is. Just a reminder now, Flexx is only 23. So I find, like, the older I'm getting, the kinkier I'm getting.
Yeah.
I could see me going that route, to be honest.
No, but it is, though, because, like...
Like, what about bondage?
Yeah.
Yeah, but like, yeah. I'm not gonna, you know, wouldn't go out of my way for, wouldn't yeah. be like, right, first of all, do you have a bondage set? And yeah. if they were like, no, it's like, oh, it's done. Like, yeah. Nah, I'm pretty, I am, like, it's
so you're open to trying things. Yeah. But you just don't have something specific.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
he hasn't had the experience yet. No, he's waiting for the experience.
Yeah.
yeah.
Waiting for the experience. If anybody has a bondage set out there, tip legs up. Yeah, or a big pen.
Yeah, pretty much. You
know? This is for his girlfriend. Oh, his sorry. Current. Oh, I don't there know if he, he's calling girlfriends and boyfriends. Yeah, so his girlfriend. Yeah. He's going to learn with
you
her.
You heard it here first, lettuce. An exclusive.
Right, next question.
Go on.
Flexx, have you ever had sex with any of the fans after a gig?
Whoa.
No. No, do you know what?
There was an M.
Do you know what, right? It's like, I have, but it's not like there was someone like at the gig.
I knew the person.
But like, you know, I'm kind of tricky like that with certain things. It's not that I have to like know the person or anything like that. I don't. But like, I've had someone who's been like really interested in my music, was at a show, and then that was it. But we were talking for a couple of weeks before.
Yeah, you'd build like...
So you have to have some sort of connection. It's not like you're not into like a one night fling thing.
Yeah, like I'd have... Yeah, yeah.
That must be an Aries thing, because I'm the same. I'm the same.
Really?
Yeah.
That's interesting.
I'm the exact same. I can't just go and have a one night stand.
Yeah, but like, you can have one. It's just going to be shit. Like, one night stand.
I wouldn't even bother. I've never had a one night stand. I wouldn't even bother going...
See, I have, and like, it was just... It was not. There was
yeah, but it's
crazy.
Ram bam, thank you, Matt. You know, it's the bare basics, and that's it. Like,
And then the following morning, it's just like, I have a headache. I'm hungry.
Yeah,
I need to
please
go.
Fucking leave.
Yeah, I need to leave.
That was the best thing about me and Aaron when we started seeing, like, fucking each other, like as like a friends with benefits or a situationship. He used to get up at like 7 a.m. leave the house, and then I'd be like, yes.
Oh, that's handy.
That man ain't hanging around. There's no awkward conversations. This is amazing.
No. Would you be be a sneaker outer in the mornings?
No, I'm actually like, I try to quite like respectful. Yeah. Like, I'm not really like that, to be honest. I'd be kind of like,
you're not a pump and dumper.
No. But I'm also kind of like, I'd have the crack in the morning. Yeah. Like, I'd be like, that was going on.
Yeah,
like,
but you know, when you're hungover as well, I love like the hungover giggles that you get in the morning, regardless of who's there. Like, me and Libby, some of the best laughs we've ever had is, no, that sounds weird because you're my cousin.
Have you had sex with Libby?
Yeah.
Oh.
Sorry, Benata. No, I haven't.
I
had
also
sex.
Have to say sorry. I kissed her. She was a 10 out of 10.
No, I haven't had sex with Libby. But you know those after morning giggles, like a hangover and stuff with your friends?
Yeah. Right, next question.
You can only pick one.
Oh wait, he taught us something.
Oh. No, I thought you were going to, with the way you made a face there.
Oh, like, no. Then no, that's just my face.
You cannot. Yeah, it's very offensive, our faces.
It's just how I look all the time, sorry. You'll get used to it.
You can only pick one. Give up music forever or give up sex forever?
Give up sex forever.
Really?
Yeah, I just fucking wank.
Fair. Exactly, that's
fair.
Actually really
get
proud.
A good pocket pussy and away you go.
You know, that would scratch the itch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Whereas like, what could scratch the itch of making music? No. Like, I don't know.
No, because you'd always be there going, what if, I suppose. You're not going to go, what if I didn't have sex with your aunt? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I get you. So, okay, here's the question, right?
Yeah.
Have you had better wanks with yourself than you've had sex with women?
Like,
have you enjoyed...
Not all women.
No, like, better orgasms, like. Better orgasms with yourself than you've had with women. Or is it the woman that makes the orgasms better?
There's times where it's like, you know what I mean? Like,
edge yourself.
That was
like,
a good wank. Yeah. You know what I mean? And it's like, it's been better than some sex. But like, in general, I prefer like a woman. I would prefer a woman to us.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
but not over music.
No.
Oh. I like that.
Do you hear that, new girl?
Don't make
him
choose.
You're on the back boiler.
Don't make him choose.
Yeah.
Right. Flexx, how do you feel about your gay fan base? Did you know he had one?
I do now. Yeah. I do now. Man, whoever listens to the music, you know what I mean?
A fan base.
It is what it is.
Yeah. Like, doesn't matter what they are.
Nah, they're the fan base.
Yeah,
like,
a stream is a stream.
Yeah, it is what it is, man. Like, my thing with music is like, it's just, Yeah. Like whoever enjoys it, enjoys it.
Yeah. Oh, they're not here for your music, trust me.
You don't. They're not. Fuck off then.
Tony and Tony.
Got it.
If you had to soundtrack your latest sexy time moment with a song, what would it be?
Fack by Eminem.
Fack, fack, fack.
Listen to it.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're on.
Yeah, that good. You can't even say fuck, you have to say fack.
Fack. Yeah, fack.
Oh my God. Give us a little few lines out of that song. I love it.
What was it? Oh my God, it's him. No, it was a different one, wasn't it? Fack,
fack, fack.
I'm coming. I am going to come. I'm some city.
It is something like that.
That's a weird song to have sex to, fairness.
Yeah, that would be the soundtrack, you know?
You are a bit wild then.
Yeah.
I'll fun.
Because I don't know anyone who else would pick that song. Okay. Next question, right? What's the worst sex experience you've ever had? Assuming you're not a virgin, lol.
Okay. Worst I've ever had. That's actually kind of hard. You know? I'm not even joking.
Awkward then. Something that's awkward.
Right. There was like a bathroom stall. We've all probably bathroom stall, right? Yeah. I just didn't enjoy it. Because it was just like hectic.
Was it in a nightclub or a pub?
Yeah,
there
was just someone shitting next door. Do you know what I mean?
That's not romantic.
Do you know what I mean? So I was kind of just like,
you're a fire sign, so you need that. You need that like romance and that little bit of passion
you're
and stuff.
You love connection.
Oh, I do. Yeah.
You love the connection.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, like you know, like sometimes, like you know, if you look in someone's eyes and you both feel the same, like energy.
Like, and you can get that like tingling feeling. Yeah,
you're not gonna get that in a bathroom, so
next door, you know.
Have you ever played your own music while riding someone?
Yeah, once.
What was the song?
What was the song? Actually, it was actually you can look it up on my Spotify.
Plug.
Do you know what the funniest thing about it is? It's not even a fucking sex song. When I See the Water, it's called. It's just about traveling.
Yeah.
Did you just put it on or did it come on?
I'll be totally honest. I'm not going to bullshit you once straight at this. I did put it on.
Yeah. It was your idea.
That's me.
I know a guy.
Yeah,
I know a dude.
This guy's me.
I know a dude.
Did it go down well?
Yeah.
Did she go down well?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was just kind of one of the things where she was like afterwards. This is so funny. I said like such a fucking dickhead. I was drunk, right?
Yeah, okay, that's right.
I was just like afterwards, I was like, that was me, by the way. You know what I mean?
That was my song. That was
so you had it done and finished in the one song?
Yeah. 24 and a half minutes.
So it didn't quant anything else. There was no cross wires around. No, that was me.
Yeah, we should have went through the catalogue, but we didn't have fucking time.
The song was still going when it was finished.
Put me on shuffle. That would actually probably should have been the last one, the fucking worst experience. Yeah. Jesus Christ.
Someone said, would you be interested in a diss track?
In a diss track? Yeah, oh yeah. If someone said something about me, I'd I'd mess them up on a diss track. Yeah.
You don't come across as like a mean type of person.
No, I'm not. Like, I'm not gonna like,
but your lyrics, even in your songs, are very different to who we are in person as well. Yeah. So do you feel like when, so obviously your real name is Keane, so do you feel like when you're making music you become Flexx?
Yeah, it's the one.
So it's like your alter ego.
Yeah. Like, it's the one part of my life where it's the one part of my life that I take like fucking really seriously.
Yeah.
Like really seriously. And like, so like if I'm making the kind of stage character, I suppose, is like, it's just a caricature of me.
Yeah.
Of course, so like if I'm really happy, he'll be like, his lyrics will be really happy.
Yeah.
If I'm like angry about something, he'll be really angry.
Yeah.
Mm.
Like, so you're just amplifying those. It's the same with us with the pod. Yeah. Like, we're like funny and we talked already, but this is not us 24/7, but we amplify it for entertainment. But we have so much, it's not that we're fake.
Yeah.
But like we channel all that energy into like the one area.
I think if you're
meet us on like the town or whatever, and and be like, oh, we love your pod, and we're just kind of like, oh,
so shy. Because yeah. I actually feel like I'm quite shy, it's when really I first awkward. Meet new people. Yeah. Like, but I feel so like you if you're a creative person in any way whatsoever and you're trying to put yourself out there, there is some part of you that has to let the alter ego come out.
Yeah.
But just because it's an alter ego doesn't mean it's actually not part
of
you.
Yeah, no, you're just like amplifying a certain part of yourself.
Exactly.
Like,
yeah.
That, you know what? That's actually a really cool question. Like, but like, I'm not going to jump onto a track and just start aimlessly. Yeah. Like, I'm trying to spread a cool message. Like, you know, have fun, like live your life. Like, but so that would mean like, if someone was coming at me, there'd be fucking really no reason. Yeah. So like, then I would absolutely defend myself. Yeah. Like,
what would someone say about you? You're too fucking beautiful.
Yeah. You wore that green jumper too many times.
Fuck you.
Yeah.
Fuck you and your
stop
beautiful
putting
eyes.
Big pens up your arsehole.
Yeah, none of that has any weight, you know what I mean? So it's just like,
yeah, it'd be irrelevant.
Yeah,
really,
it's
like.
Irrelevant.
So
like,
it'd be more of a crack to have a diss
crack.
Do you know what I mean? It'd be more for fun kind of, rather than actually like being at each other's throat. Like,
I'd so have like, if someone like mentioned me in like a cool way, I'd love to say something back
to
them.
But it's recognition as well.
Yeah, exactly.
So like the opposite of a diss track, what's the opposite of a diss track? A compliment track.
Yeah,
an homage track.
Excuse moi.
I would absolutely defend myself. I think that, you know, that everyone should. If someone comes,
I'm gonna make a diss track about Flexx now. Just so he'll write back about
it. That'd be fun.
Next question.
Let's do it.
Next question for Flexx, right?
Okay.
Tell the girls a dirty confession that you've never admitted before.
That's probably the big story.
Oh god. Yeah, to be honest, like,
no, don't
we need another one.
No, we need another one.
Damn. That's actually really tough. I'm actually trying to think. I'm actually really like, I'm an open
think about
book.
It.
What's the most obscure thing that you've wanked off to and you felt so much shame after it? Because everybody has one of those stories. Like, what was like, be honest. If it's too bad.
Oh, he has it.
If it's too bad, we'll cut it out. But if
I'll definitely fucking say it here anyways. Someone giving birth.
Really?
Yeah.
I was not expecting that.
No, that was my first.
There's a huge kink for pregnant women though. That's weird now.
Yeah.
But the fact that it was your first wank doesn't make it weird. Because anybody get off to their first wank. Literally, if somebody looked at you.
Do you remember
your
first wank? I remember the first time.
I remember the first time he came.
I was like,
after it.
I was like, I was so worried. I was like, what the fuck just happened? And I was like,
I would have always like masturbated, but I never came.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
No,
so
I
would have like, everybody had any woman out there.
Yeah.
Any woman out there that says that they didn't have a home teddy, you're lying, because every woman had a home teddy.
Oh, I had a home teddy.
Everybody had a home teddy.
That's the first time I came.
Yeah. No, I never came at my home teddy.
You watched something as
well. You literally had a teddy and you humped it.
You humped it, and that was it.
Like, I remember like my bed was like a 4-poster bed. Edge, but not like the high one, it just had the bulb at the top of it, and I used to like, if I walked by it, I'd be like
mad.
I never came from it though. But then when my mom was like,
but see, he's young enough that he has the internet, so his first wank was obviously
we're ancient
woman giving birth. Woman giving birth.
We were rubbing fucking sticks together to get a wank, you know what I mean?
That's crazy. I can't imagine it without the internet, you know, like you go home from school and you have to think about the girl.
No,
you can't just look her up.
What happened to me? My ma gave me a porn DVD.
Your ma gave you a porn DVD.
So I remember like the internet was kind of wasn't only starting out, but
why,
like,
did your ma give you a porn DVD?
Me and my ma have a very open,
that is
like,
weird.
Yeah, but like, I just grew up with like a sex positive house, not a sex positive household.
Here's
there was
a porn
no,
DVD.
There was no like rules or regulations, like, and you know, she was like, from very young she was able to tell me all about like, you know, my body and how my body worked and all. It wasn't inappropriate. It was never inappropriate. Yeah. Like, my ma gave me this DVD at 21 years of age.
Oh, 21.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because she was a latecomer.
Yeah.
Okay. I was
21 when I first had my first orgasm. Because I was like, really? Mommy, I can't. Because everyone used to say, I was like, oh, I can't have more. I was like, Mommy, there's something wrong with me. And she was like, no, you just need good porn. Here you go.
Yeah.
So then I sat there and it took me about 45 minutes to get into it because I felt a little bit uncomfortable. I was like, this ain't going to work.
But yeah, because you'd be thinking about your ma.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But then eventually, the more I taught about my ma, the harder I came then, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because mine's not dead, you know? Sorry, Sandra.
My mummy.
No, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, no, I
it was it wasn't an inappropriate age that she gave me this. Like,
no, yeah, that actually makes sense then. Yeah. When you say
so
that,
what age were you then when you were wanking?
Yeah, when you had your first wank.
Oh, like 11.
Yeah, 11.
Like 11.
But
yeah.
I've heard of men like being able to wank, and like, now this sounds weird talking about this, but like from the age of like 9 and 10, oh, that's so young.
Earlier.
Yeah.
Earlier.
Mm-hmm. Like bringing up a son, I'm kind of like, ooh.
No, yeah, that's I said if her son is 4, I know he wanks all over.
I know he does.
Man.
He does. Anyway.
That, yeah, mad.
Next question.
If you could have a threesome with 2 people in the music industry, who would it be?
Let me see. Zine and Jay. Yeah, yeah. That's actually pretty. That's pretty.
Zine and Jay.
Yeah. I'd probably say, oh, you know who I'm loving, actually. You know, Doja Cat.
Oh,
really?
Yeah,
I'd
yeah.
say she's a fucking animal in the
yeah,
bedroom.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Doja Cat. Yeah, what were you going to say?
I was just going to say her personality.
Yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't be attracted to her or whatever.
No, you Scorpios are always freaky, though.
Right, who else?
Doja Cat and, let me see. Miley Cyrus.
No.
I love Miley Cyrus. Yeah.
Do you know Megan Thee Stallion? Fuck, she's.
Oh yes.
No, Billie Eilish.
No, Megan Thee Stallion.
I don't even want to treat some. I wouldn't want to share her. Like just Billie Eilish.
No, but Megan Thee Stallion. Like,
do you like Billie Eilish?
Yeah, I love Billie Eilish. Yeah,
she's
yeah.
fucking sexy as yeah. fuck.
She is. Jade. She's very hot. Like,
isn't
she? Is. Yeah.
Even Jade came home the other day. She's like, I have something to tell you. And I was like, what? She's like, I fancy Billie Eilish. I was like,
I walked straight into the bathroom. Goes, I fancy Billie Eilish, and that's all I'm gonna say about it.
Because Jade hates Billie Eilish because she thinks for some reason that me and Billie Eilish are going to get it on.
Yeah. All right. Look, yeah. I mean, if the podcast keeps going.
I love her confidence.
That's
in
what
me.
She said, because we were like manifesting to interview at Electric Picnic this year. And Jade was like, well, if Billie Eilish is there, you're not interviewing her.
There you go.
We're like, Jade, what about her career?
Come on the cards.
Right. Okay. Here we go.
Right.
A serious question. What got you into writing music? Do you think it helps with impressing the girls?
Jesus, okay. That is weird. It's funny, like the normal question throws me off on this, on this podcast.
And
that,
yeah, it'd be like, what did you shove up your arse?
So what got me into writing? I actually, to be fair, it was the one thing, like I used to always, like since I got a phone,
yeah.
I was like, since I was really young, I was writing poems and
so I find a lot of musicians start off with like poetry poems, and so fucking love poetry,
and that was like something
it's so
like
underrated, like
and like I'd say the only person I told that to was probably like my dad, like that's something that I would have never like told anyone around me when I was doing it when I was really young, but like I really loved it, like I love the idea of having someone feel something from something you wrote.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So, I love poetry, but like I never felt that kind of shunned it, because I'd write poetry but I would very rarely share it, but my dad,
you're
like,
very good at writing poetry,
but my dad is like amazing at poetry, like he could write like 4 sentences and a 4 sentence I'd be bawling.
Oh no,
he can
that's
pack
class.
That much emotion, and he's done that. The man must have about 30,000 poems.
He should have been a rapper.
My ma kept them all.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if a little short ginger cork man would be a great rapper.
That's what they all look like here now.
I was gonna say, look at your man, Mango. What's his name? Do you know the Irish rapper? Isn't it Mango?
Mango.
Mango. Yeah.
He wrote poetry his whole life, and like my ma kept all like the love letters that he used to write her, and I used to read them.
Cool.
But like he'd sit there and we'd be just chatting or whatever, and he'd be there, it's all in post-it notes, so like he'd do either big writing, and he has real cursive writing, so like he'd be able to put like a full blown poem, and there's just like post-it notes everywhere.
Do you remember any poems you wrote when you were younger?
I don't remember like the words in it.
Do you remember
the
context?
I remember the context was like, it was basically about stepping out of your body and like looking at your life from like above, and just kind of, you know, trying to steer it in the right direction. But I was only a kid. I was really young, and like it was just kind of, I suppose that was like the groundwork of like wanting to make music.
Have been spiritual or anything like that? That would you grew up in like not a spiritual but like an airy fairy household that you would have
not at all. Like definitely, like there's kind of half my family, like my dad and all that, would believe in like God and all that, you know. Whereas
But would it be a religious end or would it be more a spiritual end that they believe in God? Like,
you know, I don't want to like speak for him, but I feel like it could be more of a religious.
Yeah,
kind
of
side.
More perception of.
Yeah,
what
that
believe.
That's
yeah.
what I would say. Like, to be honest, like whereas I'm always trying to find my feet with that kind of stuff. Like, I love the idea of like manifestation and all that kind of stuff.
I think there's endless learning when it comes to things.
We'll never know. That's the cool thing about it.
We'll
no one will ever
know. We'll never know until we die.
Yeah, exactly. which is cool. I love that shit.
Yeah,
I know.
I love all that stuff.
Yeah, hopefully
well.
Soon.
Hopefully soon. Yeah.
Hopefully I'll be dead. Hopefully I'll be dead
soon. It's your turn.
Right. Okay. If you could date any other Irish music artist, who would it be? P.S. I'd love to have a date night with you.
Ew. Oh, damn. Oh, that's actually, that's, yeah. That's clever. Clever.
Feed that ego.
Clever. Yeah, clever.
Irish artist, I would.
An Irish artist, yeah.
Jazzy.
Oh, actually, that's actually a really good one. You know what? Jazzy would be a cool date. She would be.
I'd say she'd be a right laugh on a night out.
Yeah, she would. Yeah, she would.
I like Jazzy.
That would be fun. That would be fun, yeah. That was cool. There's also another girl. She actually, I've spoken to her like briefly on social media. She seems really cool as well, Cubana.
I've never heard of her.
Yeah, it's a cool name. Yeah, check her out. She's
what's her type of music?
She actually, I think, like, I could, again, I could be so wrong. If she sees this, she's gonna be like, "What?" I think she's from like Cuba or whatever. But she makes really cool music.
Yeah,
she seems like seems cool as well.
Yeah. Your girlfriend sitting at home going,
You know, this will be all like a date is in like a coffee or like you know what I mean. Have a chat.
This is
like,
hypothetical.
He can't help the questions that came.
I can't. It's nothing to do with me.
No. What was her name again?
Cubana. Yeah, she's really cool.
She's getting the coffee.
Yeah.
Hi. First of all, I fucking love your music so much, I need advice. I recently saw a text on my girlfriend's phone from a guy she's in college with. I found him to be quite inappropriate and hoped she would shut it down, but she continued the conversation and played into it. What do I do?
Here's your chance.
Oh, what do you do? Okay, like straight up. Gone. Yeah. Get rid. What do you think? Get rid. 100%. Get rid.
Yeah. Red flag.
Whatever.
No, but if she, if there was innocence to it, in my opinion, she'd be like, "Look, I'm really sorry about that. You know that it came across that way. Blah blah." But the fact that she continued it on and played into it,
that's not innocent.
After he expressed that he wasn't happy with it.
I like how we just skipped forward to I got the phone anyway, and I flicked through it. Like he just went in there. Yeah, I know. I think he's right, man. Like.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks as well, bro. Like, I mean, that's cool. Like,
but, thank you for the ego boost.
Yeah, but no.
Sorry about your missus.
Yeah, sorry about the missus. No, like, if there's anything, it's like, that's just a sign that that's long term, that's a good thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's a good thing. Yeah, well, especially that you saw that.
If it's something that makes you uncomfortable and she doesn't take that on board, then
it doesn't matter what it is.
Doesn't matter.
If it makes someone uncomfortable, then you have to respect those feelings.
Yeah.
Right. Bro. Bro, you're handsome and all, but you look like you could have an STI. No hate, it's really a compliment.
That is
a play.
Have you got an STI?
Well, first of all, we should tell him it's not actually anonymous.
We're gonna get you.
We got you.
If it wasn't actually anonymous, we'd have some lot of people locked up.
Yeah. Right, no, we would. Yeah. Have you ever had an STI or scare?
No.
You're like one for protection.
Oh, yeah. 100%. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
You've never had a scare. See, he's only 23.
Yeah,
No, it's all ahead of me.
What age did you lose your virginity? 7.
Yeah. One of my teachers.
I was grammed. It's all coming out now.
It was hot as fuck.
Miss and McIntyre were coming for you.
Were you one of the Catholics?
He taught me English.
He was my religion teacher.
Yeah.
He was a priest.
Yeah. Let me see. The girl is going to be like, no, that's wrong. I was late enough to it, I think. I think I was like 17.
Yeah,
I was 17.
That's cute. So plenty more time for STIs.
I think our generation, to be fair, lost it a lot younger due to pressure. Yeah. Whereas I find like the generation now, it's more aware that it's like, it's okay to wait to have sex. Whereas like our generation, like, well, the fuck.
I love this generation. I think this generation gets a lot of hate for things.
No, but they are like, they're really making steps.
They are.
They're really making steps. Yeah, 100%. Yeah.
Living for themselves. Like, do you know what I mean? It's not. Yeah, we're just all bastards.
Was it a good experience or was it an awkward?
No, good. Really good.
Yeah.
Really good experience.
Yeah. I've been with the girl for a while anyway, so.
Oh, that's so cute.
Yeah. Just like shitting on herself.
He's so fucking perfect, isn't he?
Fuck off.
Right, go ahead, Danny.
To Flexx, what is the most down bad thing you've ever heard of somebody doing?
Oh, I won't name this.
No, obviously not. You can't.
You can tell us after.
Close friend. Yeah.
Close friend.
Told me this recently. Again, we had a couple of drinks, if I'm not mistaken. We had a couple of drinks. Could be, I believe my find it insane that you'd make this up.
Okay.
But so he said, right, that he was in school with a girl. This mm-hmm. is secondary school. So like he was 16 around okay. that age. And there was this girl that he had like a massive crush on, right? And they were putting money together for a ski trip.
Right.
Okay. So on a piece of paper that was written from her, he saw her address.
Right.
Okay. Uh-huh. Now I don't know like why yeah. he saw the address, but it was on an envelope, and she handed it to the teacher, right? And he was behind her, and he was like, "Oh shit, that's her address."
Yeah.
And so he looked up the address on Google Earth and wanked off to the house.
What the fuck? Now that's a first.
What the fuck?
To her house?
Wanked off to the fucking house.
Her house.
Her house.
Like, right, just knowing that she's in
that
there.
That she's just like been walking there.
Oh
like,
my God.
What the fuck? I really didn't know where that story was going, but if that's not the end, and that was I was anticipating.
No.
She goes in there.
That must have been some sexy fucking house.
What the fuck?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's weird. He's going to grow up to be like a Jeffrey Dahmer.
Yeah,
what
no.
age is he now?
We were talking about
he's
that fucking.
24
now. Yeah. He's a psycho.
Yeah, no, and do you know what as well? We were all drinking as well, everyone just stopped.
Yeah, well, you would.
Like
we're fairly open. I've never heard anything like that before.
No, yeah. I've wanked to some weird fucking shit. Never to a house.
No. Well, maybe that's what I'm missing now.
Maybe. Do you know what? I'm going to pull up Google Maps later.
Mm. Pull up my house.
Yeah. I'm going to pull up Google Maps later. I'm going to find a sexiest house.
My house is the sexiest house.
Yeah.
Look at the fucking windowsills on that. Mm.
Yeah.
That
baby hasn't been painted in a while. Let me paint that.
Right. Yeah.
Let me spray all up on that. That bitch needs a power hose. Yeah.
And you could do that.
And I can
you
do could it.
Do that. Right. Flexx, have you ever met any famous people?
I met John Cena.
Oh no way!
Yeah. It's just me like this. But I did. I actually met him when I was really young. My dad brought me to a wrestling thing, right? Yeah. It was in Dublin. WWE were in Dublin. So we went in, we stayed in the hotel, and I actually met all the wrestlers because the person behind the counter was like, "Oh, the fucking the wrestlers are staying in here." And we're like, "No fucking way. No way." And so yeah, like we saw all of them and I met all of them, but like I got a really cool picture with John Cena.
That's
so
really?
Yeah, that was cool.
Was he nice?
Oh, God.
He's actually meant to be absolutely lovely. No, I've heard he's meant to be really lovely.
And there were some of them that just weren't. Like, I don't know if any of you are like interested in it, but CM Punk was there.
No.
Dick.
Really?
Absolute dick. Like, really? Oh, God.
Asshole.
You prick. Dick. I wanted to say that since I was 8. Yeah. Dick.
Fuck you.
Like,
what's his name?
CM Punk.
CM Punk, you fucking asshole.
Bastard.
How dare you treat Flexx like that?
Was it?
Skank.
Yeah. They were really cool. They were really, really cool. Yeah, but I was only a kid. But
CM Punk playing the character,
though.
Like,
No. Who else? Mike Malone, the footballer.
Go away for Liverpool.
Yeah.
I don't know who that is. Yeah, well, my dad's an avid Liverpool fan, so I know all them.
And then, there could be someone I'm leaving out. But I think that's it. You guys, I suppose. There you go.
I have some for advice. Right. Gay couple here.
Oh, dang it.
My girlfriend doesn't want to have sex with me. If we do, it's more like a quick one and she just gets it done with. She won't let me touch her either, so it's always one-sided. We talked about it. She says she feels like she's asexual now. What should I do? Any advice? I'm a horny fucker.
Get rid.
Then a bin.
Yeah,
if it's too hard, it's not worth it.
Yeah, so I think the first thing, like, even from like my experience, I was in a 6-year relationship.
Right.
And like, I know I'm quite young and all that, but...
Yeah, but that doesn't matter. Age is irrelevant.
Yeah, so I have, like... I think the best thing is, like, talk about it. Like, bring it up. Like, and if you can't bring it up, there's something wrong. Like, if you feel like you can't talk about
that. But obviously she's brought it up, though, and your one reckons that she's asexual.
Yeah.
I'm not dissing on asexuals because I know there's an asexual... Like, that is a real thing, right? Mm. But I also feel like some people will say that... Mm-hmm. because it's not even that they're asexual, but they just don't want to have sex with that person. And they don't realize it's that person that they don't want to have sex with. They realize that there's something, they think that there's something wrong with them, that they don't want to have sex with them. And then they come out of that relationship and then they're like, okay, my sex drive is back. And then they realize that it actually was them that they didn't want to have sex with.
I get you. I get you.
You get me.
What do we think then? Is the consensus like have a good chat about that? Like, because if one of you
have to, that's have the only chat. Answer. But for me, sex is a massive thing for me in a relationship.
Oh, yeah.
Sex is extremely important for me in a relationship because that is the foundation of intimacy.
Yeah.
And without intimacy. Yeah, fair. Now, I'm not saying that it's extremely important, but it is quite important for me.
It's very important.
It is. I think it's one of the most important things in a relationship. I'm just trying to be nice there for people to say it.
No, we are lying. Be honest, Annie. Why are you trying to be nice at all?
Sex is so important.
No, we're human. We're human.
You can't. Why? Are you with someone that you don't want to have sex with? Then it's what you can't. What's like the point? That's not right.
You're friends.
But as well, exactly, friends.
No, but as well, and this is not shitting on asexual. If your partner is asexual and you find sex a massive part of intimacy, you're not compatible.
Yeah.
Regardless if she's asexual or
regardless if she's asexual,
you need to move on. In my opinion.
Yes.
Well, can I say something? Was she asexual before? And you knew she
was. No, but clearly not though, because so she said not anymore. Yeah, so it's not even that it's an excuse. I honestly feel like that person is like, doesn't want to have sex with her partner, but they're like, well, why don't I? There must be something wrong with me, without even realizing that it's that person that I don't have sex with anymore.
Yeah.
Because I was in a very long term relationship. I was in an 11 year relationship and our sex drive like died out towards the end.
Yeah.
And it did. And I thought there was something wrong with me.
Yeah.
Because I've always been an over sexual person my whole life.
Yeah.
Regardless of who I was with. And then and this is not against the person, we're like really good friends and I get on really well with him. I just was not sexually attracted to him anymore, but I just thought there was something wrong with me because I didn't.
Yeah.
And I wasn't. And he wasn't for me because he never initiated it either.
I get you.
So when we split up then, I don't know what he did.
Yeah.
But like, I found my sex drive came back tenfold.
Oh, I'm fucking sure it did. Oh, Lord.
And then when I found like Aaron as well, and I have a really good connection with him, now that I have a good connection with him, like my sex drive is right back up to where it was years ago.
Yeah.
So I find it's definitely, there's like a deeper root cause.
But it's the same with me though. Yeah. It's the same with me because I have never had as much sex or as good as sex.
Yeah.
With anybody ever in my whole life until I've met Jade ever. Now I don't
but
know
it's connection based like
what
it is
I don't know what it is like because me and Jade absolutely murder each other.
Yeah.
But maybe that's the whole thing.
Yeah.
We fucking kill each other, but then we're like,
that's passion. That's passion.
Me and Jade like, I fucking hate you, you bastard.
Get inside me.
Oh, makeup sex is the best.
Yeah, that works.
Passionate sex is the best.
Yeah, no, like, me and Aaron haven't got to the point where we've had makeup sex.
But like,
sex
if you
yet.
And like your girlfriend, like we're absolutely killing each other. Do you find it more of a turn on having?
Yeah,
sex
but they're very fresh, so I doubt they'd even had a fucking predicament yet.
Yeah, makeup sex.
Yeah, not.
So like me and Aaron are quite fresh as well. What are we together? Like 3 months or whatever. Yeah, but that we weren't connected then. We're only connected the last 3 months.
Right, what do you think, Flex?
Just in general.
Yeah. That's good. I think that should be a part of it. Like, I think that's part of the process.
Yeah.
You know? But like, you'd nearly rile your partner up because that little bit of aggression, but it's like passion as well.
Yeah. Right. We've made up now. Let's go.
Yeah. Let's go, mom. Well, that's all I've got.
Right. Okay. I have the last question. Right.
Okay.
But I've also put something together.
Ooh.
Right. So I got a question in. Right. Can you even freestyle, bro?
Oh.
So we're going to put it to the test.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
We have come up with a couple of words for Flex to put into a freestyle.
God, that was the casino came up with this. Right? I'm unaware.
So Flex, are you up for the challenge?
Yeah, 100%. Let's go.
Okay. So the words that I've come up with that you need to freestyle and incorporate all these words in are pussy liquor.
God, Jesus Christ. The first one.
Finger blast.
Bam.
Foreskin.
Boom.
And anal bleeding.
Jesus, that's two words.
Right.
So look at my look
pussy
licker,
finger
study
blast.
Them, right,
study them.
Pussy linger. Pussy linger.
Pussy linger.
And I have
to let it linger.
I have a beat and everything for you, right?
Oh, you have a beat.
I have a beat.
So I have stuff like I'm gonna incorporate those words into some stuff
you've already written.
I have out there somewhere. Right. Oh. Yeah.
I have a beat for you and everything, right?
Right, you ready?
So I'll play for you. Let me know when you're ready. Right.
Okay. Okay, right.
You ready?
Yeah, okay. Are we going from the...
Oh, shit.
Oh, damn.
Ready?
Okay. I'm About to beat this beat like Chris Brown did to Rihanna. Smoking other rappers, treat them all like marijuana. You about to lose your mind like that dude from Nirvana. Fuck peace, I'm here to bring the drama. We only fucking once, bitch, so take a picture. This is as big as my dick gets. I told you, it doesn't get no bigger. That's why I'm strictly a pussy licker. Guaranteed to make you finish quicker. Turn off the lights and you finish before it even flickers. Lady stuck to me, that's why I call them stickers. Been fucking since the playground days, that's why they call me a swinger. Got you hitting high notes, you ain't even a singer. If you cheating on me, I'll beat your ass on Jerry Springer. I'm a walking, talking, mortal sin. You wanna see a shark coming? Check the dorsal fin. You wanna see me coming? Pull the foreskin. But don't you dare put it in, cause then you'll have me supporting abortion again. Haha. I'm a pain in the ass, just like church seating. Such a pain in the ass, I cause anal bleeding. I got a short fuse. I got a short fuse and some screws loose. Like, oh my god, where's the clinic at? Last Christmas, smacked the Grinch in the face, said, what you grinning at? Yeah, I'm bad to the bone, scientific fact. I can hype you up, or I can make you laugh. Okay, girl, we gotta finish fast. I just heard the sirens, the popo, they've been dispatched. We ain't got no time, so forget the dick. Take this finger blast. That's what I did to every girl from my fucking past. Don't be flattered, I like ugly ladies. That's why I met the dairy girls and fucked the whole cast. Made them wear a mask, take it back to the COVID days. Have the whole world sucking on my ball like a load of gays. Okay, okay, let me out of here quick. I'm hungry, I need some grub. I'm getting angry now, I might wreck the studio like I'm in the Chamomile Club.
Okay. Yeah! See ya, that's it.
Fucking brilliant.
Oh, God.
Very good.
I hope did it come
that
out?
That was fucking brilliant.
Did it come out?
No,
okay.
It was perfect.
That was brilliant.
That was so good.
That was
good.
Really good.
Really good.
Dairy Girls
cast. I love that. If anything's gonna go viral, it's that. I'm telling you now.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
Are you in freestyle?
No.
Are you?
I can't freestyle.
No,
I couldn't freestyle. I don't know.
Like, what about like a certain like verse, a certain part of a verse of an Eminem song?
Of an Eminem song?
Yeah.
Oh! Do rap god.
Oh, go on then. Right?
I can do rap god. Will I play it to the music?
Yeah, go on.
Yeah.
Right, okay. Rap god. I vape now. Right? So... the thing is, right, you need a lot of breath to be able to do this. And it takes a lot of skill, Flexx. You might learn a thing or two.
Yeah, I'm ready.
You might learn a thing or two. It takes a lot of breath because you have to do this whole thing in one breath, right? Okay. And I used to be able to do it, but I vape now. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it, right? Mm-hmm. So let me just get the song up.
Okay.
And we'll see. Right?
Go straight to the radio station the very next day. Move back. Next to the
I'm a mommy, you be some yummy. What I gotta do to get it true to you? I'm superhuman, innovative, animated, rubber, so that anything you say is ricocheting off of me and it'll glue to you. I'm devastating, more than ever demonstrating how to give a motherfucking audience a feeling like it's levitating, never fading, and another haters are forever waiting for the day to take. Say I fell off, they'll be celebrating, cause another way to get them motivated. I make elevating music, you make elevating music. Oh, he's too mainstream, but that's what they do when they get jealous, they confuse it.
Oh, yeah! Yeah! That was so good! That was really good!
That's how you play on.
Out of 10, what'd you give my rap skills?
Oh, fucking 12.
Really?
Yeah, that was really
12.
Good. Yeah, people are going to be like, oh, 12 isn't smaller than 10.
You would you have me feature on one of your songs?
Oh, 100%. I
will hold you to that.
Yeah, I'd love to. I'd love we all made it. Fucking
right. Yeah, definitely. Flexx, right?
Yeah.
Right, your real name's Keen, actually.
Keen, yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So, where did Flexx come from?
Yeah, I was just going to say, where did the name Flexx Carter come from?
Yeah, so if you ask me that, right? So I literally, you know, there's like name generators. Yeah. So I basically kept fucking around on one of those until I found a name that wasn't on Instagram, Spotify, TikTok, so I could get like the handle. I wouldn't have to put underscores or numbers. Yeah. So I just thought of a name
Flexx Carter. It was just a random generator.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, yeah.
That's cool.
No, but it's a cool name.
No,
that is a really cool name. Flexx Carter is a really cool name.
Yeah, my real name is Keen Walsh. So like, there's nothing.
Keen Walsh.
I can't look at you as Keen Walsh. Flexx Carter.
That's fair. Yeah,
I gotta call you Flexx.
I like that. That's good.
Right. Yeah. Okay. In one of your lyrics, right, you say usually got carpo tunnel from the swipe rights, but I feel like you've got carpo tunnel from probably wanking too much. So which one is it? Have you really got carpal tunnel from swiping right?
I do both at the same time. So,
what's your go-to dating site?
Do you know what?
They're all ridiculous.
I'm not into them at all. No. Like that. that lyric was to kind of that was to kind of reach out to the people
vague.
That were
yeah,
that,
I get
that
you. Was, yeah. You wanted to make a relatable kind of yeah.
Do you know what it was? It was like I feel like when you come out of a relationship, you kind of are like, oh, duh, take the box. I have to try out one of those. So I tried out the ones and I was just like, oh, this is weird. It feels like fucking shopping or something. Do you know what I mean? So I was like, nah, I much prefer in-person connection.
Yeah, people use like them as an ego boost.
Yeah.
Literally as an ego boost.
Yeah. Like even the girl I'm with now, it's like we were really good friends for years.
Right.
You know what I mean? So
that's the start of a love story.
Yeah, so it was like it just that felt like natural, whereas like
no, but it's fake though, yeah.
Yeah.
I was never really into dating sites either. I find them uncomfortable or something. Do you know what I mean? And then like meeting I've had bad experience with dating sites. I've been like talking to people and I've invested in talking to people and then meeting them in real life and they do not look like what their fucking
That's
pictures
the thing.
Like.
It reminds me dating sites remind me of like, you know when
it's a hookup site.
Yeah. You know when influencers put up like, here's what I ate today, and it's like the best meals from fucking breakfast to dinner.
You're only getting
like
shown highlights.
Yeah, you're just showing your best day ever. Like that's the same with the pictures.
Like I was in a relationship for a long time, so when I became single, that was my first, as like a 30 fucking 2 year old woman, was my first time on a dating app. Mm. So I was like, oh yeah, this is definitely to try find like a connection with someone.
No,
that's not what it is though.
No,
the first message I got off Tinder was off a woman going, massive mommy milkers.
Yeah, I remember you texting me, massive mommy makers. What?
That was a fella. That was a dude.
No, it was a woman. It was a lesbian. Yeah, yeah.
No, because women are fucking stupid as well.
It was a masked lesbian.
Women are stupid as well.
And I literally unmatched her and she tried to match me for about a year after that.
What was she thinking? Yeah. Thinking that was going to be
massive
mommy
milkers.
You know, that's going to
travel her.
And the only reason I remember, because it was the first message I ever got on it.
I'm so sorry. I apologize. On behalf of all lesbians in the world, I apologize. That was the very first message you've ever got off any other lesbian.
Oh, no, well, I've got some fucking obscure things on it, but I'm so glad that's in my past.
It's in your past now.
Fucking hell, yeah. That was set the tone, isn't it?
Okay. In one of your songs, right, you said,
Zena's done her homework.
One of your songs, you have said, she's behind me and she's looking fine, open back tattoo, down the whole spine. If she was behind you, how did she know you were fine? She was fine.
Wait, what was it again?
So you said she's behind.
No. Oh, yeah. So that was there's a lyric before that about wanting your soulmate to be behind the headlights, like when you're walking along in the night, and it's like, but tonight she's behind mine.
Oh,
so she's behind
okay.
She's in the car with me.
Right, I get you.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I was reading through your lyrics, and I was like, how did she know she was fine if she was behind you?
Yeah. There you go. There you go.
Yeah.
So that's
she know she had an open back tattoo if he was in front
exactly.
of her.
Exactly.
Yeah. So that was it. It was meant to be like we're both in the car together.
So,
she's behind my headlights.
Right. Okay. So is this an actual real person? Do you know someone who had an open back tattoo down her spine?
Not rhymed.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Yeah. Sometimes you just gotta put the fuck in. You just.
Actually. Do you know what? The girl I'm seeing at the moment, we did like this. I think she's gonna watch this, right?
Of course she will.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, so, she's gonna be like, oh yeah, there. You know those fake tattoos?
Yeah.
We put one on her back. Mm. Like she fucked with getting like a spine tattoo.
Yeah,
so we just put one of those fake ones.
Don't
like
do it.
Dragon. So yeah,
it's
we did.
So sore.
we did
don't
that.
It.
That was it.
The different. Yeah, the look. Dag away you with your little fucking line.
That's it. Yeah,
it's not comparable.
I don't know. I don't think she's gonna go with it. But they look good.
Do you like a girl with tattoos?
Like the only.
Oh, I am so attracted to tattoos. Yeah. Mad into them.
What is her gay?
Mad into them.
Doesn't matter.
Don't matter.
Right. In one of your songs, you said, "Oh, in one of your songs, when I see the water, right?"
Oh,
you said.
Yeah.
You're fucking prostitutes in Berlin. Nah, just kidding.
Nah.
But I feel like you're not kidding.
Kidding? Yeah, not kidding.
You've never fucked a prostitute?
Nah. That's actually just my.
It just rhymed.
Yeah, it just rhymed. Yeah, no. Like in every song, even if it's like a really serious song or whatever, like I try to put in like dabbles of like my own humor.
Yeah.
Like if I'm making something, I'm kind of like.
But that's what makes it memorable.
Yeah, and I'm making a song. Yeah. To be honest, I'm making the music I want to hear.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
That's
so
it.
that's why I make music.
You're sitting in your own taste.
Yeah, exactly.
Well.
So
as much as you try to please everyone, you never will.
Yeah, and that song is about like traveling and all that. And it's like I've been in all these places with my friends and all that, and I've been like, nah, no, just
yeah, fuck prostitutes yeah. everywhere. Maybe not in Berlin, but everywhere
yeah,
else.
Everywhere else, yeah. 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 I lied about the Berlin part.
Have you even ever been to Berlin?
You fucking fraud.
He's a phony.
Maya
he's
passed, a fraud. Maya passed through it. I'm trying to think, I might have passed through.
He's a fake, he's a phony, doesn't even know what Berlin looks like.
Yeah, yeah. The fuck is,
how do you spell it?
Where the fuck is Berlin?
Yeah, how do you spell Berlin?
B-U-R, that's what I meant. Burr. It's cold there. Yeah.
Right, okay, getting serious now. Okay. We're coming to the end of the podcast,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
And I want to know, right, in an interview with RTE, right? You said, deep down, I'm just a nerd who likes to make things rhyme and I'm going to change the world. So I want to know, how do you plan on changing the world and what's in the future for Flexx Carter?
Right, so my real mission with music is, it is to change the world effectively. Yeah, like, it's to make people...
It's make to people be relatable, kind of.
Yeah, it's to make people believe in themselves. Mm. Like, I mean, every single day, people go on social media now, they get abusive messages.
Yeah.
You can't fucking escape negativity anymore.
No. Mm-hmm.
And people make music and all of it is negative. And it's just, you know, like, I even listen to the radio sometimes.
It's relentless,
and
it's like.
Downbeat shit on the radios. Yeah. Mm. So, like, that's why I'm trying to get my music out there even more on the radio and all that, because someone might listen to it and be like, oh, actually, you know what? I feel like I can do that, despite what everyone's... Yeah. Everyone beats down on you every fucking day. That's just how it is. So it's like, honestly, just fuck everybody. Like, people are going to tell you not to do this, not to do that. If you believe in you have to believe in yourself.
Yeah,
you exactly. know, that's the thing. So I want to... I basically, long story short, I want to make everybody that listens to my music believe in themselves and push themselves on and all of that kind of shit. And, like, that's why I appreciate, like, this platform even, like, because... Yeah. It's like, I truly believe, and I have stuff ready to release. I believe the more people listen to my music, the more people will be happy, the more people will believe in themselves, and the more people that won't give a fuck what anyone thinks about. Yeah. You know what I mean?
That's the thing. Changing one person at a time. And it's the same with this podcast. It's like, if we can say something, we can say something in this podcast that makes one person listening go, do you know what? I actually don't feel so weird anymore.
Yeah.
I don't feel so alone anymore. And that's the thing. So it's like, not even changing the world, but if you can change the world for someone else, for one person, that's the goal.
That was fucking extremely poetic. That might turn me on a little bit. You're absolute weapon.
You know what I mean?
And you know what?
Wow. That was stunning.
Even like listening to this. We're sorry, were you going to say something?
No, you go ahead. You're beautiful.
Sorry. I am.
Go on.
Like, even listening to this podcast. Even listening.
One day at a time.
To this podcast. Like, even listening to the podcast and like doing the podcast, it's like there's so much things where it's like it's so funny to listen, it's so funny to do and talk about it, but it's like there are 100% people that are listening to this. This is how we all talk to our fucking friends.
It is,
it's when you say it out somewhere that it's like oh, that's so weird, and it's like, shut the fuck, that's how you talk. Like, that's how we all talk to our friends. And it's like, you know, it's like, if you're weird, good, you know what I mean?
But that's what people think, that they can only have those conversations with their friends.
Well,
you can't. It's not only your friends, everybody has these conversations.
Mm-hmm.
Whether you feel uncomfortable for being talked about outside your friend group, then that's okay. Like, you know, it's not a normal conversation to have, but that doesn't make the conversation any less normal.
No,
that you can't have it outside of your little friend group.
Everybody is fucking weird.
Everybody
thinks weird things.
Humans are disgusting.
We think
vile.
Things that are wrong.
Yeah.
I think things that are against the fucking law.
Yeah.
Things, intrusive thoughts, everything.
Yeah.
We're all the fucking same. We all have them, regardless of what people try to say. And through Flexx's music and through Unhinged, we're trying to change the world.
We're
trying to change the world.
100%. One day at a time.
100%.
Anyway.
Flex. One Berlin hooker at a time.
Kean Walsh.
Thank you so much.
We are Flexx Carter. Delighted to have you on. Thank you so much. Let everyone know what your handles are on Instagram.
Yeah, so Instagram is just Flexx Carter. It's two X's. Okay.
Kiss.
Same on TikTok. And YouTube, I'm out there now with all the music videos, and of course Spotify.
He has just released his first music video as well, which is pretty fucking epic.
Yeah.
So check that out on YouTube.
I've wanked to it twice now already. It was only yesterday.
Only twice.
Jeez. But give me time.
That makes sense.
Did you have fun?
I had so much fun. Like, genuinely, to everybody. Like, I actually mean it. Like, swear to God, like, thank you so much. Like,
thank you.
I love the year. Fucking brilliant crack. Everything is just like
so much fun.
Yeah, you're and dead.
I'm only 26.
Yeah. So I hear. Yeah. So I believe. Yeah. So I believe.
Yeah.
You're right. Brilliant.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Everyone, let's give a clap for. Yay! Okay, thanks everyone for listening to the Unhinged podcast. We'll see you in the next cartoon.
See you in the next cartoon.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.